Hello everyone, so today we will see about the EDCOM module 1.4. So the title of that module is Foundations of Communication. In this video we will see only about the principles of communication. So today we will learn about the how to communicate and what are the principles of communication. Even if we will also see about the cultural communication or cultural competent communications. Okay, so today we start with the foundations of communication, how to communicate, and firstly in this video we will see about the principles of communication. What is communications? Exchange of thoughts or information, exchange of whatever we feel, that to in form of information to different person, or maybe it may be in form of verbal, it may be in form of writing, or it may be in form of non-verbal, that is signs. That is all known as communication. Now, effective communication. The communication which ultimately produce an information accurately, which give or which we can pass the information accurately, that is known as effective communications. So effective communication is the result of getting the desired response by sharing information between people accurately. Now communication process, it is two-way process, that is one is giving the message and one which receives the message. So it may be in form of information or any signal. A message communication process is three step, that is first the messenger or the sender, message of the sender is received. First the receiver receives the message from the sender. Second, to understand the communication method or message by the receiver, and then ultimately the desired feedback is sent by the receiver. That is all known as communication process. Now elements of communications. The communication has four elements, that is one is message. So the information or message is one element. The second element is medium, which is the mediator between sender and receiver. And third is sender, and the fourth of course is receiver. So these are the four elements of communication. Now principles of communications. The communication principles, this means the validated guidelines that is used to perform different tasks. To make communication effective, few guidelines are there, and these guidelines we can remember in the form of, or these principles we can remember in the form of 7 C's. These are the 7 C's of communications. The first is conciseness. So the communication, what we want to communicate, the information should be or message should be conveyed in concise form. Concise form means short form. So best, shortest possible way we have to confirm or communicate the message. Second, it is clarity. That is the message what we want to communicate should be clear. So because this clear message is a specific message and it focuses on specific message at a time, it helps receiver to understand easily and clearly. Then the third is correctness. The message is correct. We have to transfer a correct message. Because if the message is correct, it boosts up our confidence. Because if we want to communicate something wrong, then of course we are guilty and we won't be able to communicate correctly. And our confidence will be loose. But if the message is correct, clear and concise, then these all things, they boost up our confidence. Then it is coherence. Coherence means what? Consistent and logic the communication which we want to communicate should be, the message should be coherence, that is, it should be consistent and logic. It should be a part of sender's message, it should be a logic, and it should be in communicating flow, should be consistency, that is, it should be regularly maintained consistency. Then the fourth is courteousness. So the sender person, the what the sender should be respect the audience. It should be polite, he should be polite and enthusiastic. He should complete reflective, see, these all things, courteousness or what you say, kindness, politeness, enthusiasm, these all reflect our sincerity. So the message should be always, the messenger should be courteous. Then the completeness. So the information what you want to communicate should be complete and effective. Because when the information what we want to share should be complete. So the information should be complete. Then the last one is concreteness. So concreteness means what? The message should be clear and specific. There should be no chance of misinterpretation. And the message, if it is concrete, it includes only facts and figures. And it strengthens the message. It gives strength to our message. The message should be concrete. Now, what is effective communication? We have seen. Now we come to the protocol. For communicating effectively, the protocol is TIMER. So TIMER, T stands for think through the encounter, introduce issues, manage the discussion, establish a plan and expectations, revisit and give feedback. Now T is think through the encounter. So we have to be sure that what you want to give information is right. That means the information, data, whatever you need, you try it for it. The information should be right. We have to assure first that. Run by others if you need. If the information is not right or you need some more information, then please try or tell others and get the proper information by the others. Have an endorsement of the one-up to avoid being undetermined. So if it is undetermined, then we have to avoid one-up. So we have can gather more and get the endorsement from others also. Then rehearse what you want to say, rehearse it, and then put yourself on the feedback head and strive the people or person to improve performance. So you have to first rehearse it and feedback it through the encounter. Then introduce the issues. I is for, so how to introduce the issue? First, meet on their turf if possible. So try everything. May not lead to productive conversation. So you have to get all the information. Clearly state the issue using I statement. Then we have to clearly state what you want to say, the issues. And use I statement. I statement like this: I am worried about it, but it is happening. Anything you can say. I am concerned about. I have something to say you. And in this way, you use I statement and clearly state the issue. Then next is provide facts. Avoid personal stuff. So we have to provide facts, whatever are there, and don't use personal stuff. In going over, I see that. In this way, you can introduce your facts and maintain eye contact. So we have to be in eye contact with the receiver. Then M is for manage the discussion. So try to stay calm. We have to stay calm. Focus on what the other is saying. Try to be non-judgmental. We don't have to be judgmental or personal. It's about changing behavior. Use tell me more to clarify. We can use something like this. Please tell me more about the unfair treatment. Can you tell me more about what happened with your father or whatever to whom we are discussing. Use 6-second rule. This 6-second rule means what? Ki you have to be, if your emotions are boiled, you take wait for 6 seconds until you be calm. So if you are in angry, then please take deep breath and wait for 6 minutes and become calm and then start your performance. Reaffirm the other person's issue so that I hear you saying this or something like this, and you can reaffirm the other person's issue. Align with the person by acknowledging and validating emotions with empathy. Then use empathy. I can see you. We weren't expecting like this, but your father's condition is getting like this. You can use the word. I know that there is this is hard for you to hear. Like these words you can say and follow the empathy. I see your points. This increasing the dark about it or something like this. You can use, and then use wish statement. You can also use after that to manage in the discussion. You can use wish statement like, I wish I could change it. I wish I had better than, and I wish that I did it. I did not have to revise the issue or revisualize the issue or something like these words you can use. And wish words you can start with that and manage the discussion. Then E stands for establish a plan and expectation. So when emotions subside, work on the problem together. State your expectations. That means it's important that we resolve these. Negotiate, brainstorm, collaborate. That is, what are your ideas and how we can do it like this. You can establish your plan, ke how we can do it. State your goals, that I did it like to see you try this. And goals should be smart. Smart means it should be specific, measurable, achievable, resource and timed. And lastly, you summarize all what you have planned and what you expect from it. Then R is for revisit or give feedback. State purpose of meeting. So you have to there in that case you have to see the purpose of meeting, that I wanted to meet with you to follow up now. Then you can review agreed upon goal state agreement, like get their perceptions, how are things going in that, all you can take it. Then praise effort, that I appreciate your work or something like this you will say. Then you can give the feedback that you have really improved on, or you can say to the patient, very good, you followed my and that's why you have improved a lot. You are improving, doing very well. You have struggled with all the defects, and this all you can give the feedback. Brainstorm to further improve performance, that what will it take for you to hump this up to a notch. You have to show them that how this the mountain of problems will be solved, and this all you have to visit or give the feedback. Then culturally competent communication. Its fundamental principles are cross-cultural medical encounters are increasing in multi-ethnic societies. That's why we need to get the cultural competent communication. Cultural competent communication means these are the factors which influence survival rates and patient and family quality. Cultural competence is a set of attitude, skill and knowledge that can be acquired. It respecting cultural diversity is key to delivering comprehensive cancer care across the illness trajectories. Cultural competence promotes patient-centered care through sensitive negotiation of therapeutic goals. Why cultural competence can help you to plan a patient care? So discussion of cancer is a taboo, like in some cultures. In some cultures, they feel that cancer is a very bad disease. It is associated with death. Some feel that it is same disease. So that's why we have to give a cultural according to the communication, according to the cultural competence. The patient from delivering diverse culture rely on different healing practices that can often be incorporated into care plans. Ethnic, genetic, culture differences can affect treatment response directly or through lifestyle. Where you need cultural competence most? Truth telling about diagnosis, there you need a cultural competence. Prognosis, where there is risk. Discussion of death. Issues related to family involvement in information. Use of alternate or complementary cancer treatment. Reliance or spirituality for healing. Attitudes towards psychological or behavioral counseling. Concerns regarding clinical trials. This all needs cultural competence. So 7 areas which we cover under the cultural competence are balance. The protocol is balance protocol. B is belief and values. That means that influence perception of illness. Then ambience, that is living situation and family structure. Then L, that is for language and health literacy, that is the role of interpreters or accuracy we can find out. A is affiliations, that is community, lies, religions and spiritual behaviors, beliefs. Then network is social support systems. Challenges means the disease related risk at home, at work, whatever it is, in hospital. Then E is economics, that is socio-economic status and community resource. So thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe. In the next video on the ATCOM module, we will see about breaking a bad news, how we can break a bad news if there is to the patient or its family members. So next video, please do watch that video, second video also, then you will complete the foundation of communications. So in this video we have learnt about the principles of communication and cultural competence communication and their protocols. Oh, thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe to get the more videos.